Grace and peace, grace and peace. This is Spreading Truth Ministry, and thank you so much for listening. I'm Prophetess Diaz, the founder of Spreading Truth Ministry and the founder of Spreading Truth Ministry, House of God and Prayer for All People offline. Amen and amen. I do appreciate each and every one of you for taking the time out of your busy schedule to watch and to listen to this broadcast. So, you don't have to do it. You don't have to click subscribe. You don't have to like this video. You don't have to make a comment. You don't have to share the videos that are on the channel or do anything of the sort. And so I do appreciate you for subscribing, for commenting, for sharing, amen, for liking the videos, and even for doing the opposite, amen, because without you, I would not have an audience, and a purpose to share these videos. And so I thank God for you. I hope you had a wonderful week. This week has been interesting, especially in terms of the weather. The weather has been very, 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 very interesting. Some days it was so warm where it felt like spring. Other days it was snowing. The next day it was raining, sleet, just all kinds of things going on with the weather. But nevertheless, we just thank the Father, amen, that we are here, amen, and that, God has kept us through the week, and we're just resting in Him. Happy Sabbath for those that observe the seventh day Sabbath, amen. Shabbat shalom, Shabbat shalom, amen. To my brothers and my sisters, my Hebrew brothers and sisters, my Jewish brothers and sisters, we just want to bid you that peace, amen, that Sabbath peace, amen, in the name of Yahshua, Jesus the Christ, amen. And for those that are not Sabbath observers, we bid you peace also. We bid you shalom, amen. And then we thank you for watching the video as well. And we're just grateful, amen. We're just grateful and we're just thankful for what the Father is doing in the lives of His people, because truly God is moving. He's working. Amen. God is. He is. You have to believe that. And that's why we're going to talk about faith on today. I mean, God is moving despite of what you see, despite of what you hear. There's a lot going on. I mean, we can look at the politics, the political aspect, of what's going on that's impacting our world. Amen. From the head on down, whether it be federal, whether it be our state, local, there's some movement. There's some things that's going on that's impacting us as citizens. There's things that are going within the school system, the shootings and all the different things that are going on, and through the entertainment system and just all kinds of things that can really impact you in a negative way if you're not careful. And so it's important that we maintain our faith. And so I just want to talk about faith on today. I know that this particular topic is definitely familiar to most people that we go into Hebrew, amen, to get that definition, to define what it is and to understand what it is, amen, so that we can allow that word, that term, that belief to manifest in our lives. And so we eat it, we breathe it, we live it every single day. And so I just want to encourage you in that way, because that's what God has called, the ministry to do, is for the perfecting of the saints. Amen. It's to make us a perfect man. And so, if the area of faith is low for you, if that's a struggle area for you, if that's an area that hasn't been fully developed for you, I just want to encourage you in the area of faith. And trust me, as I encourage you, I'm encouraging myself, amen, because we could all need, amen, we can all need a boost, amen, of encouragement, amen, especially in the area of faith. God said it. He said it perfectly through His word, that faith comes by hearing the word of God, because He knew that there would be moments where we need a boost in the area of our faith. And He tells us exactly what to do to get that boost, whether it's someone giving it to us directly or we're encouraging ourselves indirectly through the word. Amen. Hallelujah. And so we just magnify God for His word. Amen. For His word indeed is truth. And we thank God that it is powerful. Amen. The word of God is power. The Bible says sharper than any two-edged sword. So we just grateful to God for the precious word. And so that's why we need to hold to it. We need to read it, study it. Amen. We need to especially read it audibly. Get in the habit of reading it audibly. I know sometimes we like to read it silently. Amen. But get in the habit of reading it audibly. There are times where I may even play use the auto player when I'm reading the scripture so that I can hear it. Amen. And therefore building my faith. Amen. As I hear the word of God. So let's talk about faith. Amen. Most of the time I read the King James Version Bible, but I like this particular wording of Hebrews 11 and 1. And so let's talk about it. Faith is being sure of what we hope for and certain of what we do not see. Again, faith is being sure of what we hope for and certain of what we do not see. And so let's look at that. Let's look at that. There's something, amen, that has to happen in the lives of every believer that is inspirational. That is inspirational. And I believe that it happens by way of the Spirit, by way of the Holy Ghost, that we're inspired in a way and encouraged in a way that gives us hope, that gives us certainty that something is going to manifest way before we see it, way before it becomes tangible. That we have a level of hope and certainty in whatever it is that God has given us, whether it be a vision, a level of understanding, whether it be something that we've seen, by in a dream or seen in a vision, or God has given us a vision by way of the Spirit, or whether we actually visualize something, within ourselves that something's going to happen before it happens. I believe that that's through a godly inspiration. A godly inspiration. It is something outside of ourselves that has given us some level of insight about something that will happen, that will occur before it occurs. Amen. And so it's so important that we protect it. We protect the idea, that we protect the vision, that we protect the dream. Amen. That we protect it. And that we protect our faith in it. It's important that we do that. It's important that we build our faith, that we build our holy most faith, the Bible says. It's important that we do that. How do we do that? The Bible says in Ephesians, the sixth chapter, talks about the whole armor, the entire armor of God. And then it talks about the shield, right, which is faith. And then he says that we're to use the shield to block all the fiery darts of the wicked. So our faith is multi-purpose. Our faith is used to block the fiery darts of the wicked, and our faith is also used to maintain a hope and a level of certainty in the things that we don't see as of yet. And so we're certain. There's no question. There's no doubt. Amen. In our minds, that this thing is going to happen and this thing is going to materialize, regardless of what's going on around about me, regardless of what's going on in war, what people are saying, or how people are feeling. That doesn't matter. It doesn't affect what is to be. And so we have to have that level of faith. We have to maintain that level of faith. And I would like to say that we have to be stretched in the area of faith to the point where we have the gift of faith. That nothing will influence us outside of God when it comes to the vision, when it comes to the dream, when it comes to the plans that God has concerning you. And what I love about the Father is that He will not only inspire you, but He will give you, amen, a level of uncertainty and a level of hope beyond. See, the Bible says that you can hope, that hope maketh not ashamed. That he can give you a level of hope that regardless of what goes on around you, you still won't feel ashamed. That somehow when that thing eventually comes to pass in its season, because you don't ever want something to happen before time. You want it to happen in its season. Even the Bible encourages the vine to not cast its fruit before the time in the field. So it's important that it happens. That there is a manifestation in its time, in its season. And during that, between the time that the vision has been released and the time that it's manifest, that's the time of process. Amen. God is preparing you for that time. And so my thing is, and I want to encourage you in this area, is to allow God to process you. Continue to hold on to your faith, continue to block, amen, all the doubters and the haters, continue to block, amen, all the fiery darts of the wicked. continue to block, amen, the influence of outside influences, of people and places of things, because even your situation, when in terms of your environment, can affect your faith. And I'm going to give you an illustration of that. Let's say you're living in poverty. Let's say you're living from paycheck to paycheck. Let's say you're living, at a place where you don't know where, amen, your means are going to come from, or whether your needs are going to be met. And your environment is so bleak to the point where you just don't know what's going to happen. So you can literally allow your environment to influence you and say, you know what? This is my lot. This is the way it is. My family was raised, through the projects. I'm just going to always be a person that's in the project, or I'm going to be always a person that's, impacted by poverty or oppressed by poverty. I'm always going to be a person that's working for somebody else, and I'm never going to have my own business, or I'm never going to be an entrepreneur, or whatever, whatever. You can allow your environment. You can allow, for, your experiences or the family's experiences to impact your vision. But you have to get to the place where you don't allow any of those things, whether it be your history, whether it be your experience, whether it be your environment, to affect, what is to be, to influence your faith. You can't allow it. No matter who believes in you, it doesn't matter what they believe. God did not show them the vision. Come on, somebody. Now, there may be times where God will give them a glimpse of what it is that He's trying to do, because the Bible says that we prophesy in part and we know in part. Okay. So there may be times where God will give them a glimpse of what it is that He's shown you. But the fact of the matter is that He's shown you. And so therefore, we cannot depend or rely on what people say or feel about what God has given us, because God has not imparted that, the fullness of the vision, to them. So it's not their responsibility to believe in it. It's yours, because God has given it to you. He's trusted you with it. And so therefore, you have to take it, you have to work it, you have to run with it, and trust God that it will come to pass. I believe that He will not make you ashamed. The Bible says, hope maketh not ashamed. You're hoping in God for it. You're believing God. You're working what you got, because the Bible also says that faith without works is, come on, somebody, dead. So you're working your faith. You're working the faith. You're working your gifts. You're working your talents. You're positioning yourselves. Amen. You're planting. Amen. You're sowing. Amen. Glory to God. You're doing everything it is within you. Amen. Glory to God. You're in the right spirit. You're postured correctly. Amen. Hallelujah. You're working on yourself, and you're letting God work, working things out in you that's not like Him. He's positioning you. He's processing you. You're letting Him work. Amen. Glory to God. So that when the time comes for manifestation, you're ready. You're ready. Amen. You're ready, and you're still believing and holding on. Amen. And until He takes you to the next level. Amen. Where you're going, your faith is going to have to, increase, because I believe with every level, there's a level higher of challenges. There's a level of higher in testing and assessment of what we've then experienced and what we believe. And so I thank God for faith. I really do. And you have to do everything to maintain it, everything to, to keep it and to hold on to it and to build on it. The Bible says we should build on our holy most faith. And the Bible says that faith comes by hearing the word of God. It's just so important that we hear the word. So I want to encourage you, as you read the word, play it out loud, play it, play the recording of the reading of the word, read the word out loud, come to church, hear the preacher preach, listen to my YouTube videos. Amen. We need to hear, amen, the word of God. Bible says faith comes by hearing the word of God. And so faith will continue to build as we hear more of these types of messages, as we listen to it over and over again, because you're going to need it, especially if you have a vision that's humongous. Amen. Where it seems impossible, almost. It seems impossible, but nothing's impossible for God. And that's what you have to maintain, that hope and confidence in knowing that there's nothing impossible for God. And if He released it, amen, if He shared it with you, if He imparted it to you, that means that it surely will come to pass, amen, and that He can do it, and that He could use you as a vessel to bring that thing to fullness and manifestation. So hold on, keep trusting God, and keep believing. Hold on to your faith. Be sure in what you hope for, and be certain of what you do not see, because it will come.